Welcome back everyone, I'm Craven and this is Trails to Azure. We are in a general store and yes, we are a bit hiding here because we don't want the authorities to find us, but we are busy doing our rounds in Crossbell during... Do I dare to say that like an occupation by Dieter, because he's technically officially the mayor turned dictator right now. So yes, we are doing our rounds. We are at the center square and we still have a lot of areas to go through. So let's not keep standing in a corner. Let's go talk to as many people as we can. Hopefully along the way, maybe find some hidden requests. Let's get to it. I hope my daughter was able to return home before the lockdown. We haven't been able to use orbital communication since that declared martial law. I'm so worried about her. Well, at least we can still get some decent ingredients. And I'm still missing a few recipes. Do hope eventually we'll find it. Or else doing all the cooking doesn't help me at all, unless it's like a CP item or something like that. Which we do have. Ah, Miss Ellie in the SSS. Oh, what are you all doing here? Martial law hasn't ended, has it? No, unfortunately not. Oh, I was afraid of that. How has the department store been managing, Neston?
Well, per our customer's request, we were keeping our doors open for as long as we could after martial law was declared yesterday. But then came the mist. From there, staff and customers alike began to take shelter in here. All of us have been trapped ever since.
Oh, we were expecting to hear some kind of announcement about it overnight. But the government gave us nothing but radio silence. Seriously, what are they thinking?
What indeed? Clearly, we need to intervene as soon as possible.
Well, I know you're all restless, sir, but don't worry. The SSS is currently working to bring an end to this whole situation. In the meantime, I'm going to have to ask you to keep everyone in the store until the situation outside is under control.
I understand. Tread careful out there, SSS. Ah, and before you go, please take this with you. May it serve to keep you safe.
Hey, I never say no to free items. Definitely not.
Oh, thank you, Neston. You're much too kind to us.
Oh, luckily food and daily essentials won't be an immediate concern while we're in here. The longer this continues, though, the more I worry about families at home who haven't had a chance to stock up. Why didn't the government tell us anything? Seriously, what are they thinking?
I will have everyone in the store wait out the martial law orders until further notice, as you advised. Tread careful out there, SSS.
We always do.
We need some emergency mission supplies.
No questions asked.
Oh, I'm actually a big ball of anxiety right now. Being with Southwark helps calm me down, though. I never thought a man could make me feel this safe.
I'm glad he does, really.
Well, have your loved one there for you is reassuring during crisis like these. Maybe this makes me a sap, but it fills me with courage I wouldn't have otherwise.
Yes, we know, we get it. Special edition, already own one of those. Yeah, that we're doing reasonably well when it comes to items. Yeah. Who is waiting it out in here?
How long do they plan to keep martial law in effect? Most families likely have no more than a week's worth of groceries stocked up. I deeply dread what might happen if this isn't resolved quickly.
Anything new in the meantime? City walkers? Does have evade?
Don't see any increase with Lloyd, and that's the only person I'm looking at it for.
At first I thought for certain that it was the CDF who protected us from the Empire's railway guns. But the truth, like most of this whole mess, is making me feel anything but relieved. Isabel, all that talk about establishing a United Nations was just for show.
Yeah, or it was just a test case to see if he could do this the normal way before going all crazy with his Aeons.
At first I thought they were certain was the CDF who protected us from the Empire's railway guns.
Alright, what do you have? This is the baser ones. Still good though. Oh, I know they declared like martial law or whatever, but they could have warned us about the mist or those big grotty night guys outside. I so should have gone home. I mean, even if we went home, we'd just end up stuck there instead. Low-key though, I guess I could do kinda miss my family. Oh, the president was confident no one could attack us so long as we have those Aeons as weapons. But he failed to mention anything about the armored knights we have marching around town right now. The lack of transparency is troubling, to say the least. All they've managed to do is frighten the public.
Well, that is basically what he is doing right now. But isn't that what most dictators do? By a show of force, try to stay ahead of the curve?
Theo, yeah, that's what you were wearing probably before.
Not a bad dress, but we've got better.
Nobody out here in the mist. Does look a bit ominous, doesn't it?
Alright, let's get out of here. We still have a restaurant to check out before heading over to the next region.
Didn't think about you big guys.
Oh, did the government intend for this to happen? All the crazy stuff going on in the city. Why didn't they give us more warning about it? Things wouldn't have turned out half as chaotic.
True, but saying to the public, oh, we're gonna pump a lot of blue mist throughout the streets to whatever reason, and then let golem knights walk everywhere. You might be scared, but as long as you don't bother them, they won't bother you.
It would probably help a little bit, but I think it would still be pretty scary.
You're with the police, yes? They say you've been operating independently of the CDF. Is that true?
Yes, it is. We're trying to find a peaceful solution to this whole affair. Oh, has your restaurant been in any danger?
No, we've been alright. Other than the few customers stuck here, it's mainly been me and my staff.
I would expect the circumstances are calmer here than at other businesses. And since we're a restaurant, we have plenty of food to go around.
I see. Well, that's a relief to hear.
That being said, the situation outside isn't likely to become any safer at any time soon. We would appreciate if you could have everyone remain in here for the time being.
Understood, ma'am.
I go to the restroom for one moment and suddenly this blue mist has us stranded. What in the world is going on here? More importantly, what are those giant mechanical knights patrolling the city? Are they supposed to be protecting us from Erebonia and Calvert? I'd say we deserve an explanation for this.
True, because without any information, your best guess is the only thing you have.
And with the blue mist and walking golems, yeah, I wouldn't come to a peaceful conclusion myself.
I love watching my cooking bring joy to others. There's no greater honor for a chef. Knowing a customer likes our food so much they'd visit even during a crisis like this, that gives me strength.
Oh, it's pathetic that it took the city falling into chaos for me to realize this, but I finally understand what Brown has been trying to tell me. A chef is only as good as their last customer's review.
It's true.
For so long, I only made dishes to satisfy my own ego. I couldn't believe how much of a tool I've been.
Yep, but as long as you learned your lesson, at least something good came out of all of this.
Alright, let's check if there's any more. Oh, Mimi and I went to pick Abel up from work, but then this terrifying mist forced us to take shelter here. Supposedly, those old mechanical creatures can recognize citizens, so there's no risk they'll attack us. But even still, I can describe how terrifying it is when one of those things glances my way. Oh, guess what? The nice people here gave us food for free. That was so yummy too.
Well, since I work for the city, I had to stay overtime to help residents find shelter. I didn't have time to go home myself. But somehow, Sally and Mimi saw it coming, so they left to find me. Now we're all stuck here. Well, I wish they would have stayed safe at home, but I'm happy to have them by my side. Yeah, and it's at the location that you know has food. There are a lot of different places which are worse off than this. So you'll be fine. No one up here. Okay. Well, I think for the next regions, we're just gonna do it the old-fashioned way. Doing it counterclockwise, meaning we're going by the harbor. And then just going around in a circle until we're back at the center square where the SSS building is. And here and there, we're probably gonna fight a golem or two if we feel like it. I don't think it's necessary. I think we are pretty good and... Well, how much would they give in experience? Probably not that much. Crossbell City Urban Development Division. This is close as well. Danger ahead. Do not enter. The noodle store is gone too. There's not a lot to do at the harbor, is it? Over a three-month period of the Hundred Day War, the journalist was committed to deliver war coverage with the utmost honesty and sense of justice. In commemoration of this event, he is hereby awarded the Pulitzer Prize, November S. 1192. Yeah, we know who won that prize. Back issues of the Crossbow Times sit on the shelves. Do we want to read this? Because I don't think we missed anything, did we? Let's check if we're allowed to go upstairs. No, there is no receptionist. Yes. Oh, hey, it's the SSS. It's good to see you're all safe. Grace let us in about the situation you're in. But don't worry, our lips are sealed. While we have you, though, would you be up to swap a little info on what's going on out there? We'd love to. Well, I'll be damned. You guys are really planning to break into August Tower? Pull that off and you might actually be able to topple this authoritarian regime. No place for me though. Just when I thought I'd be easier to get around this lockdown, orders went into place. Not to mention, all our comms have been jammed ever since that blue mist appeared in the city. So, it's even affecting normal orbital communications. The mist must be emitting some sort of wave that interferes with the signal. One more reason to take care of it quick, otherwise the city is gonna get more and more restless until chaos breaks out. I hate to say it, but you're definitely right. By the way, are you three the only ones in the office right now? Yes. The rest of our staff got stranded while they were out on assignment. Thankfully, we've been able to get in touch with almost all of them. All of them, except for Reigns, that is. He's the only one who we've lost contact with. We don't have a clue where he is or how he's holding up at the moment. Reigns? You mean Grace's partner? Yep. That said, he's bound to still be someplace within city limits. Oh, I just hope he doesn't take after Grace and do something reckless. To be fair, he's proven that he knows how to handle himself, so I'm not too worried. That about sums it up on our end. I know you guys have more important issues to worry about, so get on out there. We'll be gearing up to report on all of this when the news breaks. Until then, gotta speed on the operation. A failure's not an option here. Somebody gotta put a stop to this tyranny, one way or another. Right. Rain's missing? Grace is probably worried about him too. We should try to keep an eye out. That we should. Is any place where we can see maybe his desk on what kind of thing he was working on? By the way, SSS, you got my thanks for looking after Grace. Take care out there and leave the story of the valiant efforts to us. That we will. Oh, we're drafting a news bulletin based on the intel Grace gathered for us. The thing is, under regime, we can't even write about the present injustices. It's pathetic. That's why I'm betting everything on you guys breaking into the tower. Someone's gonna put a stop to this. Yes, because controlling the news, that never ends well.
Oh, I hope Range doesn't do anything reckless. But more than anything else, I just pray that he's safe.
In all honesty, I hope that too. Is there any way here that we can...
I'm still trying to see if there's any way that we get hints on where he actually is for an assignment.
Because I do know that there was a hint in the comments about where to go after the harbor. So we can check out that quickly, because it's just the next door in the next region. So let's see. Because I did say to go here after the harbor. I don't see anybody here. And the hint was look behind the counter. There should be something you can interact with. But is there?
Theo? Is something bothering you? He was faint, but I sent someone over in that direction. My apologies. I don't believe it should be of any cause for concern.
Well, alright. Yeah, I don't think without a hint I would have found this. Cause, yes, they did say looking out in places, so only if I went to the harbor first and then checked out the east street would I have figured this out. Like this, just me doing the east street first and then coming here? Yeah, that is a long shot, but let's see what she detected.
There's a hole leading into the darkness behind the wooden planks against the wall.
Oh, that definitely looks like it leads somewhere. A section of the geofront, perhaps?
And these planks don't seem to be secured to anything.
Well, think whatever you sensed earlier is in here, Theotod.
I believe so, yes.
That is rather concerning.
Do you want to check it out?
Yes, let's check it out.
Yeah, it wouldn't hurt to check, just in case. Then, without delay.
So, this passage really does connect to the geofront.
Indeed. We appear to be part of the D-Sector. The presence I detected has gotten stronger. That being said, I can only sense a single person down here.
Well, they're behind the door, I assume.
Yes, there's no room for doubt.
Do you suppose this is a warehouse or something? There's some glazing on the door we can look through.
Well, I can't say either way, but at least we have a convenient way to check. Let's see if we can assess the situation from here on, before making any moves.
That's Range, right?
Right, that's correct. Yes, Colonel.
I called you what?
Oh, sorry about that, Director. Force of habit. Wait, I think I recognize him. Is that Range? The reporter from the Crossbill Times. What could he be doing here? Is that the SSS over there?
Mind coming inside for a chat?
Damn, that was fast. So much for being sneaky. Oh, never mind that. I think we should listen to what he has to say. Just don't let your guards down.
Nice, got it in one.
Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you guys. If anything, I'm surprised to see you here.
Well, we were thinking just the same thing about you, Reigns.
Oh, it seems you were quite a few heads, junior reporter and photographer for the Crossbill Times, Grace's partner.
Well, I think what she's getting at is that there's more to you than meets the eye. So cut the egg, buddy. Who are you, really? You didn't bail when you noticed us. Probably means you're ready to spill the beans, right?
Of course. But just so you know, the Reigns you know was never an act at all. This is the way I really am. Anyway, the truth of the matter is that I work for a private intelligence agency.
An intelligence agency?
Well, it's a company called RNA Research. We are based in Liberal Kingdom.
RNA Research.
I feel like I've heard that name somewhere before.
As have I.
Well, we've only just been established, so we're really nothing special. Well, but I suppose Director Richards is famous enough to get people talking about us.
Richard!
Oh, is that what the Colonel started? Is this the company, the RNA?
Huh. Really nice connection. Now wonder, have you seen Rains during the Trails of the Sky then?
Richard, you wouldn't be by chance mean the former Colonel of the Royal Army?
I can imagine anyone else he could be referring to.
Do you two know who he's talking about?
Yes, his name is Alan Richard. He was the commander of Liberal's intelligence division, as well as the orchestrator behind the attempted coup d'etat 2 years ago.
He was the one responsible for that? Yes, though I also heard he helped resolve the Liberal incident the very next year. Her Majesty Queen Alicia then formally pardoned him as a show of gratitude. Ah, so that's what happened. And after that he used his experience to establish his own research company. Well, that's quite an exceptional resume for any man. Dang, you really know your stuff. I guess the SSS has a pretty good intelligence network going too. Shouldn't be too hard to figure out my role in this mess from here, hmm? Yeah, I think I can do the math. Oh, why reveal this to us though?
Honestly, because I wouldn't mind establishing a working relationship with you guys. It might come in handy.
The way I see it, this little talk needed to happen sooner or later. Oh, but I shouldn't let you know. Nobody at the CNS is in on any of this, not even Grace. Sorry to put you on the spot, but could you do me a favor and keep this to yourselves? From what we've heard, you and your firm seem to be a third party as far as the situation in Crossbell is concerned. As long as you do not cause trouble, we don't have any intention of leaking your identity.
Thanks, I was hoping you'd say that.
I do still have one question, however. Our communication has been jammed since that blue mist appeared in the city. How is it that your equipment is still able to function properly?
Oh, this thing.
It's affected, sure, but it still produces a pretty strong long-distance signal. Thanks to the mist, though, the furthest it can reach is just past Crossbell's borders. Luckily, that's all I needed. The director just happened to be on a business trip to Altair. He was one on the other end of the line.
Ah, I see. That you managed to establish contact under these circumstances at all is no small feat.
While we're on the topic, that comms device behind you looks like the kind that has got a built-in encryption features.
That's some military-grade equipment you're sneaking around with, Paul.
You sure have a sharp eye. I think this is pretty basic compared to what any army would use. What's important is that it's good enough to avoid being detected by the defense force. Though, cramming all that efficiency into one device means it costs more than I could ever afford on my salary. That's why I don't move the thing unless I absolutely have to. The vice director would tear me a new one if I broke it. So again, I would really appreciate it if you could keep this place on the lowdown. The cash-strapped intelligence agent.
Well, no, isn't that charming?
Well, you know how it is. Even my problems have problems. Anyway, I think that about wraps things up. Sorry for taking so much of your time. I'm going to stay here and contact as many people on the outside as I can. You make sure to be careful, okay guys? And good luck infiltrating Orcus Tower. Yeah, thank. Wait, I don't remember telling you about that. Whatever, we're on short on time, so we should get moving. Good luck to you too, Reigns. Keep an eye out so you don't get caught again.
Oh, I'll try my best.
How do the rest of you feel about this RNA research?
I don't know. That sounds pretty legit to me.
Yes, I wouldn't expect anything less from an agency established by Alan Richard. Well, there's no time to stand around speculating what they're after here. Let's focus on our preparations. We've got a tower to infiltrate. The hole behind the wooden planks against the wall leads deeper into the darkness. Rains the intelligence officer. Now, there's one I didn't see coming.
True. I didn't realize it myself.
I hope I can work with you in the future someday. As a member of the RNA research, I mean. For now, I'll be praying for your success. best of luck with the infiltration mission.
Could we just use his communication device to help us, the resistance?
Wouldn't be a bad choice, wouldn't it?
Alright, that does mean that we got a nice extra little scenes. And for now, we're going straight back to the harbor district. Careful now. And do we need to talk to the people at the CNS in order to inform them that Reigns is okay? Without revealing his identity, of course. Let's see if there's a reaction. Oh, I hope Reigns doesn't do anything reckless. But more than anything else, I just pray that he's safe. He indeedly is. Alright. It is completed. We found him, we talked to him, but no one gets a reaction. Fine.
Is that you, Lloyd? Oh, thank goodness you're all right.
Oh, same to you, Uncle Miles. What a relief.
You're telling me. Imagine my shock when I heard that you were a wanted man. Still, I knew there had to be some mistake. Not once did I stop believing.
Thank you, that means a lot. I know there's a lot to talk about, but we're sort of pressed for time at the moment. The SS is working to resolve this as quick as possible. Stay inside the building until then, okay?
Oh, you don't have to tell me twice. You all stay safe too, you hear?
Oh, by the way, Melpel Nielsen has been hunkering down here with us. This is one unthinkable situation we found ourselves in. You all stay safe out there.
Oh, that we will definitely try to do.
Oh, I feel just afraid as when those Jaegers attacked our city. Why is this happening to us? Haven't we been through enough already?
Oh yes, more than a lifetime, but we have to see these through to the end.
So is Nielsen still here, or has he moved on? Oh, there he is.
Ah, so the president has declared martial law. This may indicate that he has been driven into a corner. Tyranny, however, never lost. That is simply the nature of the world.
True, because people will just not stand for it, and eventually they will band together and try to stop it. And the one that does the tyranny never ends up on top.
Alright, no one at the juice store. I'm guessing she is probably in the civic center.
Yeah, August Tower. Not a place we're allowed to go, I imagine.
Other than declaring martial law, the president gave us little to no details about the situation. We couldn't have known things would come to this. Most people likely never had a chance to prepare. All we can do now is wait for the storm to pass before verifying the safety of the citizens.
Oh, the civic center is currently sheltering those who can't return home while martial law is in effect. Please, let me know if there's anything I can do to help you while you're here.
Thank you very much.
Oh, no reason to head through this door. Oh, my mom works in the Times department store. I can't stop worrying about her. She's fine. We just been there.
Ah, good gracious. Who could have expected any of this to happen? And the hero believed in President Kwa.
Yeah, that's a mistake more than one people has made, sadly.
Oh, you're with the police, aren't you? I remember you from last time we met. You're Vice Commissioner Pierre's wife, if I'm not mistaken.
It's been some time, madam. Are you hiding out here too?
I am. May I ask you if you've seen my husband anywhere? He hasn't been back ever since he told me he was going to Orcus Tower.
No, we haven't.
What's he doing at Orcus Tower?
I don't know. I didn't ask him.
Honestly, how could he just leave me to worry at a time like this? That man is in for a scolding of a lifetime when he gets back.
Oh, just sit tight here for now, ma'am.
There's a chance he might suddenly show up.
Alright, I will. But do get in touch if you manage to find him.
Oh, that will do.
Don't you worry. But that's a scene
we do not want to miss.
Because tearing Pierre a new one, that's bound to be a spectacle, isn't it? The door shut tight. Well, it doesn't look like anyone is inside the CPD headquarters.
The defense force closed it after the martial law was declared yesterday. We don't have time to waste here, Bennings. Let's move on.
Understood. Alright, next region it is.
The Entertainment District.
Oh, it was utter chaos when everyone came rushing in to get away from the mist. Thankfully, those metallic soldiers aren't attacking people, so things have been calming down a bit. Anyway, the sooner the situation is sorted out, the better off we'll all be.
Yeah, but it will last just a little bit longer still.
Oh, it's been a while since we were this busy. If only we were under better circumstances. Still, I'll do everything I can to make our guests comfortable until this is blown over. That is the Hotel Millennium way. Oh, I want to go home already.
Everyone's probably worried about us.
I can imagine. But in here you should be safe.
What happened to the barrier protecting the city? What in blazes are those monstrosities in the streets? I knew they would have gone home today, Qua made that infernal speech. Now I'm stranded here.
Yeah, sometimes we make good decisions, sometimes we make bad ones. Oh, my sister and I were heading home when all of a sudden that mist surrounded us. Since then, we've been taking refuge in here.
Honestly?
I thought for sure we were gonna die. Hey, where is his sister then? Oh, here.
I didn't even see her.
Oh, my brother gave me a piggyback ride to the hotel when the fog showed up. He was so cool.
Yeah, a big brother protects his little sister at all times. Even now in a crisis, these rooms are way too expensive.
And this room is huge. Oh, getting to stay in a nice room is the only good thing coming out of this ordeal. How much longer is this going to continue?
Well, had I understood the gravity of the situation, I would have taken us home straight away. We're lucky the hotel was willing to take us in for free of charge. Oh, that is really nice. No racketeering under their watch.
Our current guests were provided the rooms at zero cost. That alone is proof enough that Letitia truly cares for people above profits. It fills me with pride to work for someone like her. We couldn't ask for a finer manager.
Yeah, that is a very nice thing to do. A lot of people would definitely not do that.
Oh, pardon me, but you're with the CPD, aren't you?
We are. Would you mind giving us an update on the situation here?
Oh, of course. Our hotel is currently housing some extended guests, as well as others who were forced to take refuge here. Fortunately, we have enough food to last us about a month or so, if it comes down to it. But even then, it's difficult to feel secure when the government has left us completely in the dark. We've managed to keep the unrest to a minimum, but there's no guarantee on how long that will last.
I see. Well, it sounds we've been managing so well so far. Our team is working to resolve this issue as soon as possible.
Can we ask you to keep things under control here for a little while longer?
Oh, of course. Be careful out there, officers.
Oh, we will. After martial law was declared and the lockdown was put into place, we immediately began talking and taking in evacuees. What we didn't expect was the blue mist and those monstrous nights. The president was really lost the support of the average Cosbellan. Though, in all fairness, I imagine people are more afraid than angry right now.
Oh, that they will definitely be.
Alright, let's see if there's any Arcan Seal movement here.
Is that? Oh, the special support section.
Oh, it's good to see you're both safe and sound. Is the rest of the theater here too?
Yes, all of our staff and performing members have been accounted for.
They're in the middle of rehearsal on the newly reconstructed stage, as it so happens.
The sudden declaration of martial law and lockdown stunned us all, of course. But the troop came together and agreed to stay here and practice rather than return home.
I see. That is very admirable of you.
You're more than welcome to watch them rehearse if you like. Especially Sully. Has been practicing their absolute hardest these last several weeks.
Thanks, Balsamo. We'll take you up on the offer.
Now, we are requested to do a special performance shortly after the Crossbow Defense Force formed, but with our cast, as incomplete as it is, it would have been impossible. So we asked for more time. Once we regrouped, the troop leader wrote the script for a new performance, which we've been rehearsing for weeks. But then, martial law struck last night. There's no telling when Arcanseal will next open his doors. Still, no matter how dire things are, we're determined to perform for the public again someday. Well, then I hope it will be a grand performance. Because you all deserve it. Ah, the sudden declaration of martial law and citywide lockdown stunned us all. However, we came together as a group and agreed that we all stay here and rehearse rather than going home. I'm impressed by how focused everyone has been during practice. Hey, they're doing it for Ilya. I'm definitely certain. Wow. Ah, that's an additional scene from Golden Sun and Silver Moon, correct?
Look at Sully go.
Oh, goodness me. Is that you, SSS?
It's good to see you again, Evan. I see you're all rehearsing as hard as ever.
That we are. We reblocked the scene to place Sully at the center, and I do believe it's beginning to take shape. For the time being, our goal is to resume public performances as quickly as possible. And now that we know Ilya has awakened from her coma, we have no excuse to fall short of her grand expectations.
So you heard. No wonder you're all working so hard again. Come think of it, it's been weeks since anyone in the troop has seen Rixia. Maybe we should bring her so she can see how everyone's getting on.
Yes, I will go back and I will bring Rixia here too.
But first, let's go for the entire town before we do that. It's a good ender, isn't it? Because that way we can bring Null and Rixia with us. And then when we're done, we can switch them back to the team that we wanted. Oh, everyone is busy practicing their heart out on stage. We should go through the main door if we want to take a peek. We'll take a peek when we have Rixia with us, I imagine.
Can still do trades?
You material for 200.
This is interesting. Ooh, lock emblem.
Could this mean that if we have, like, just for discussion purposes, like, infinite amount of money, we could generate infinite amount of human material that we can do to get cloth for everyone. Because for now, what we would love to have is, well, basically 4 pieces of divine cloth, so that at least the main team that we've decided upon now will have their upgraded clothing. I expect Lloyd to not have one, because if we want to keep his evade up, I'm pretty sure there won't be one on this massive shirt that he would have then, and I do want to keep it at 100 at least. But if we gain at least 3, that would be perfect. So that means that we now have 75. That means we want at least 75 more, at least. So how much would that be? That is 75 times 2, that's 150. Add 2 zeros, that is 15k. That's a lot. That's a lot of tokens. Can we do that? tokens go to 1,000. Yeah, that's gonna take a lot of money, isn't it? So 50,000 for 1,000. And if we want 15k of tokens,
That means basically we need 15 of these more. So that is an amount of mirror that is gonna be insane to collect just for materials. I think it would be quicker to just fight enemies in areas that drop the material and gather it that way. Definitely. Yeah, it's a good test case though. And of course, fighting monsters will give us more mirror that if we don't have anything to spend it on, we can get more money, which can then go for tokens. So maybe we don't need 75, but if we can get 25 of them or something through this and the rest through just collecting from monsters, we would be there. I think that would be a good compromise to it. Definitely something for in between the episodes. Ah, I figured martial law was just a load of hooey. So instead I came to Barker to have some fun. How was I supposed to know it will get me stuck here? This just may be the biggest screw up of my life. I bet the old bag is worried sick about me too. Yeah, I can almost guarantee you that she is that. Ah, well, look who we have here. Hey, been a while, Drake. You seem like you're holding up all right. As do you, Randy. Plus, I heard you joined up with the Resistance in Mainz. It's good to see you reunited with the SSS. Well, has the casino suffered any damage? Not as of yet, no. I urge you to be careful, should you plan on going back outside. Oh, we will. You better watch your back too, old pal. Well, I made the right decision telling Elinda and Galetti to stay home once martial law was declared. There are only a few of us here, so we should be able to survive on what emergency rations we have. There's no need to worry on our account. Focus on what you need to do instead. Yeah, he's a good friend. To Randy, and a good acquaintance to us. Alright, let's make a start at the residential district at least. Okay, no car. Let's avoid him. Well, this will be in America, so is there anything we can steal here rather than not at home? I'm not saying that we would steal because we're part of the police force, but it's an idea. Because you know, maybe they have a recipe hidden somewhere around here. Ever since martial law was declared, the government stopped providing us with rations. We're going to run out of food soon if this gets up. Yeah, let's just make sure that we can conquer the tower before that happens. Oh, Mom and Dad both have high-level jobs with the IPC. They went to work at Orcus Tower when martial law started and they haven't come back since. What are we going to do? I'm so worried about them. Don't worry, I'm sure they'll be fine. You see those monsters prowling outside? Talk about creepy. Well, I'm sure Mom and Pops will be alright. I hope. Oh, now is not the time to lose hope. So long as you keep the faith, you and everyone you care about will have nothing to fear. I know how worried the children must be about Jungs and Marietta, but it's for the very reason I need to put on a brave face for them. True. Because it won't last much longer, we'll make sure of it. Alright, let's see if we can get down there without being detected. Or at least touched. Alright, no one up here. Hey, I'm going nuts, or is there a crap ton of monsters outside? What are we gonna do if they come after us? Well, Yuri, you got a plan, right? Right? Oh, shut your mouth for a second, I'm trying to think. Oh, damn it. What if everything bad in life happens to us? What do we ever do? I'm surprised the high plots are even still in Croswell. They must have missed their opportunity to return to the Republic. I'm sure they'll live. At least they can cause any trouble while they're stuck in here. Oh, damn it. What if everything bad in life happens to us? Whatever did we do? You guys were dicks about anything, and everything, especially with that car. Kate was rightfully furious with you guys.
Oh, I knew we should have escaped to Calvary when Crossbow declared independence,
but no one listens to Reggie.
Ah, why is this happening? Does Ayers have it in for us or something? What if someone harms us, the High Bloods? Who are we supposed to hold accountable for that?
Only yourself. Ah, the special support section.
Lady Ellie, you're okay. Helmer, Joanna, I'm home. I'm sorry for worrying you both.
Ooh.
Your safety has been the only thing on our minds, my lady, ever since Master Henry's declaration of invalidity. It's a truly relief to see you again.
Oh, thank you, Helmer. But unfortunately, I won't be able to stay. There's something I must take care of, no matter what the cost. Can I trust the two of you to continue watching the estate?
But of course, my lady.
Oh, Lady Ellie, everyone, please be careful. The situation outside is dangerous. Lady Ellie, everyone, please be careful.
My lady, ever since you and Master Henry were detained at Michelin, I've had trouble maintaining my composure. It's truly relieved to see you again.
Yeah, they're more than servants here. They practically are family to them, isn't it? And I do truly believe that they are being treated right here. Not like servants you've seen in other movies and stuff like that. Because if Ellie was dead, we wouldn't be hanging out with her.
Alright, perfect. This is... Damn light bulbs.
Well, at least they are very slow on their feet. Can we get out? Nice. I'm sure we can go to the cathedral, but not anywhere further, right? Check it out. We can leave the city now, not after everything it took for us to get in. Everything hinged on our plan to break into August Tower. We need to focus on that. And we shall.
Hey!
Alright. For now, we're gonna leave it here. Next time, we're gonna finish up our rounds by going to the cathedral and, of course, West Street. After that, we're gonna go back to the D section, pick up Brixia Null, and go to locations where they can talk to people. So we know Arcan Seal and Xinshan of Long Lao will be for Rixia, and Null probably her mother. Other than that, I can't think of anything. Maybe picking up the car will give a reaction, because she is the car enthusiast, so I still need to think about whether or not to take her along with us. Might be a good idea. We'll think about it between the episodes. In between the episodes, I will see if I can grind those big monsters for new material. If we can get like 40 materials off them, that would be perfect, because I'm gonna buy at least one Divine Cloth with the 75 we have right now. If we can get over 100, I will buy another one. That way, two characters, probably Wazzy and Randy, will have the big glow up. And if we can get more, either through converting our Sepith to Mirror, which will of course be through a normal shop, because I don't think we're going to be able to get into Ogre's Tower to get the better rating. So we'll just have to deal with that as it comes. And then of course, get the last one. If those three have it, because like I said, I don't think there's going to be an evade on that equipment piece for Lloyd. If it is, perfect. But if we can get those three in a better equipment, it will set us up for whatever is going to be ahead. I think that's going to be a good choice. It will be some grinding though. And I don't mind that one bit. So for now, I wish you a great night, morning, day, wherever you are. And if you're still here, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and be back next time as we finish up our rounds and talk to some more people. And hopefully, by the end of that, we still have plenty of time to pick up the car and plan our invasion of August Tower. See you then. Bye-bye.